Now we come to chapter 5, and here in chapter 5, we find it return again to this stranger woman. And this chapter, I think, should be read very carefully by the young man, because he's counseled here to live a pure life for the sake of his home. And this is the kind of sex education that God gives. I don't know about you, but I like it a little bit better. Some of the things that I'm hearing today, even in Christian circles, God is saying a pure life should be led for the sake of the home later on. And a lot of the problem in the home didn't begin there. It began way back in the sex life of the individual. Now, will you notice here, listen to him. My son, and here he is talking to the young man again, attend unto my wisdom. And bow thine heart to mine understanding, that thou mayest regard discretion, and that thy lips may keep knowledge. Now, what he's saying here is, it's wisdom now, bidding this young man to come to her school, that he might learn something. And then he goes on to say here, for the lips of a strange woman drop as a honeycomb. Now, the evil man in the last chapter, here it is the strange woman. That stranger woman was the one that came in from the outside. She was generally a Gentile. She was a prostitute. And her mouth is smoother than oil, but her end is bitter as wormwood, sharp as a two-edged sword. Her feet go down to death. Her steps take hold on Sheol, lest thou ponder the path of life. Her ways are movable that thou canst not know them. There was a famous, or probably I should say infamous, gangster in the penitentiary in Atlanta. One of the officers there told me this story about him, that this man had contracted syphilis, and if it's not taken care of, it'll go to the brain, cause paresis, and actually leads to insanity. And he said that this man had become, before he died, a blubbering idiot. Then he made this comment to me. He said, you know, he says he was responsible for the ruin of many a girl. He says, you know, it's interesting. They don't get by with it. Some girl along the route got even with him. And the warning here is against that type of thing, you see. Her feet go down to death. Steps take hold on Sheol, lest thou ponder the path of life. Her ways are movable. Thou canst not know them. What a warning is given here to this young man. And he says, hear me now, therefore, O ye sons, and depart not from the sayings of my mouth. Remove thy way far from her, and come not nigh the entrance of her house, lest thou give thine honor unto others, and thy years unto the cruel ones, lest strangers be filled with thy wealth, and thy labors be in the house of a stranger. And thou mourn at the last, when thy flesh, thy body, are consumed. What a picture of a venereal disease. And that's an epidemic condition here in Southern California. And say, how have I hated instruction, and my heart despised reproof. Have not hearkened to the voice of my teachers, nor inclined mine ear to them that instructed me. I was almost in all evil in the midst of the congregation and assembly. God says he's not mocked. What you sow, you're going to reap. God says this is the thing that'll come to pass. Our society is reaping what has been sown. And today, the gross immorality goes back to the lack of instruction in the Word of God. I sound like a square, don't I? Well, that's